massive there. That big one's working quite well. This is where it says where the colonies come from. It was a new nuke last August, and the queen was from a breeder called Ash Tree originally. It's white mark queen, and this is just where it is and which number of hive it is and what sort of hive it is. And that column is just any records from last year. Of course there aren't any because it was a new nuke last summer. And then as we do weekly inspections through the season for swarm control, and each row is a week's inspection, and you can fill in as many or as few boxes as you wish. So the first one is the date. Second one's who did it, because we've got several people who could be working on it, and so on. So let's examine what's on this thing. Run through quickly. We've got colony size, 1+3. So it's 1+3 supers. Brood in all stages. How many frames of brood? Native appearance. Everything's marked out of 5, so 5 is the top mark, and some people get confused by that, but 5 star, you think of it as 5 star if you like, is better than 1 star. So appearance is quite important to us because we think it helps us maintain a strain of bee, which we think is better, not that the strain of bee is better, but a strain in that enables you to select and improve your bee is better. It's more easy to select within a strain than to have complete mixture, which are less reliable with their offspring. Temperament, again out of 5, so see how they are in a minute. Swarming propensity, whatever you want to call it. If we don't see anything, we don't record anything. If we see queen cells, that would be it's preparing to swarm, and we might want to mark it down a bit for that. If you get through to the end of the season and we haven't seen any swarming, we'd probably give it a 5 if it's produced a nice crop of honey as well. If it hasn't produced much honey, it wouldn't be that brilliant that it hasn't swarmed, so we'd give it less. We can record brood pattern and health. So if we see a really good brood pattern, we'll give it 5. If we see it's all full of riddled with chalk brood or some other health problem, we'd mark it down lower. So think of 3 as an average figure. So it'd be getting 1s and 2s if it's poor. Honey yield, so any honey we remove from the hive, we'll record, we'll estimate how many pounds of honey that is that we take away, we put that on. And we'll record how much we feed the colony. And then we've got here comment notes, so we can write anything we think relevant to us. So we'll have a look at it. It's working away a little bit. It's a bit of a dull overcast day. They have been working really well up till now. I think the flow is a little bit in between at the moment, but there's still something coming in. There's a bit of yellow pollen going in. They're not exactly going hammer and tong, but they are working steadily. So let's see what we find. It's a big colony of bees. And they're really nice looking bees. They're all native and they're very quiet so far. Not such a good day today, so might be a bit more lively, we'll see. That's pretty much empty. Again, you can see the bees, they all look the same. And that's important to us. Doesn't make any difference what they look like really, but it shows to us that they're consistent within the strain, which is quite important for bee improvement, I think. I haven't given any smoke yet, but I don't think I'll bother for a minute. Okay, there's some honey in that one. Not a huge amount. That's pretty heavy. And some of that's capped, which is nice. Getting a few more bees down here. I'll just give them a little puff. But they're very still, they're very stationary, not flying out, they're not trying to sting us, they're just being very well behaved, really. I think this is how you should, this is how you want a colony of bees. You get a really good picture of the bees here, so you can see what they look like. They really look like a native bee, to my mind. They're dark abdomens. The hairs around their thorax a bit gingery or yellow brown, whatever you want to describe it as. So they have a, especially in the sunshine, they can have a yellow appearance, but the abdomens are black or dark. And any white stripes, light stripes, the tegmenta are narrow, not broad. If they're broad, it might be an indication of carnica. Okay. So now we're at the brood box, packed with bees. And this is a native colony. Plenty of bees there, no shortage of bees. And if conditions were good, they'd be keen on foraging. There's not that much foraging going on today. Nectar on that slide, but it's a great one for looking at the bees. And you can see not only are they quiet, they all look the same. You hear all sorts of funny things about native bees. People don't like them because they can't make a decent sized colony. They're aggressive. What else do they say about them? They even still say, you sometimes still say they're extinct, but, which is a load of rubbish. Quite a nice brood there. There's eggs around here. She's filling this frame up quite nicely. I use smoke to drive them out of the way, these lugs. But they're not. So to get back to the record guard, look at the brood on there. I mean, you could say it's too much, but don't forget these nationals, they're small frames. So they say you should have an arc of honey around them, but sometimes it's not. If this was in a commercial hive, you're more likely to see that arc of honey. But as it goes up into the first super, because she's laying well. She's quite a prolific black queen, and it shows you can get them. They produce a nice big colony. Just show you the colony and then we'll go back to the record card and see what we should write on it. I mean, I think they're just drone combs, just drone, but there's no sign of any queen cells yet. And she's built up a pretty big colony. It's a good sign. The beauty about these is you can maintain them. You can maintain this strain. If I breed daughter queens from this one, they're going to be similar to this colony. It's not going to be a hopeless task trying to maintain the strain, which is what we're basically faced with in Britain on the whole. We struggle to maintain the strain because we've mixed so many bees together that it just can't be done. All we've got is a mixture. and it's not to anyone's advantage really. And when they get mixed, when the strains get mixed, it often goes with a bit of bad temper as well. Nicely drawn out. Yeah, there's larvae in there. She's been laying on this frame as well. She's not short of output. She's made a really good sized colony. And they stand to produce a good crop of honey. There's a few of them getting a bit flighty now. So what I do is just give them a bit of puff, just drive them down a little bit, just get them out of the way. No real signs of aggression, they're very, very peaceful. Haven't seen the queen yet, I don't know if she'll be marked white. If we do, there she is, she's on this comb. There she is. She's a nice big black queen. Looks nice. And they're just happily getting on with what they're doing. I don't need to go any further, really. I'm satisfied they're not going to swarm. There's loads of eggs on there. I'm satisfied the queen is laying well, the bees are content. They've got everything they need. So all I've got to do now is put them back together. So I've got no complaints with them really. In fact, this queen, we've decided is a good one. And we're breeding from her, rearing offspring. We call her a breeder queen. Anything that we rear offspring from, we call a breeder queen. There we are. Now we've got, we're coming up for the end of May right now. And I think they've got off to a brilliant start. It's heavy. So I'll just stick all the supers back. It's pretty full, that one. Not to the edge. They haven't filled that one up yet. Sometimes I shuffle them around a little bit to get them to work the outer ones. But so, what's the date? That's the first problem. 26th of May. It's really not really occupying that top super yet, so it's probably one brood box plus three supers. I didn't actually count the brood frames, but there were plenty of them and good solid brood. So I don't have to fill that one in. I thought they looked consistently native, so I'm going to give them five for that. I thought the tempo was excellent. There was no aggression whatsoever. It's a particularly not particularly good day. The bees aren't even working very much today, but they behaved immaculately. There was no aggression whatsoever, so I'm going to give them five. Now, if say there was no aggression, but they were much more excitable, but not aggressive, I would probably give them four. If there was a bit of aggression, and they were really excitable, I'd bring it down to two. And if there was, say, quite a lot of aggression, I'd go down to two, or three, I said last time, I hope. And I'd go down to two, and if they were absolutely horrendous, and they follow me out of the apiary and so on, I'd give them one. But anything, I mean, I don't really like anything that scores three or below consistently. Certainly anything that scores two or one is out of the question. Anything really that shows aggression, which if it inerts a little bit, it could score a three, that is not what I'd like to keep, or certainly not to breed from. Swarming propensity, there's no sign of any swarming yet, so I'm just going to leave that blank. If I get to the end of the season and that's still the case, they'd score 5 because they built up a big strong colony, plenty of supers. If I went along next week and there were queen cells, that'd be a different story. Yes, they built up a really good colony before they thought about swarming, so that isn't too bad a trait. I'd probably give them 2 for trying to swarm. And if they try to swarm when they're only small, which does happen with some colonies, you just give them a 1 for that. The brood pattern and health, they all look healthy to me. There wasn't any load of chalk brood or anything like that. And they were good, solid brood. I think the brood was excellent, so I'd give them 5. Some people like to see honey round the top and bottom of the brood. The thing is, when you've got a nice prolific queen like that, in those natural frames, it wouldn't show. You can see that if you're using bigger frame boxes like a commercial. You're more likely to see that. But anyway, I think that's excellent. So I'm giving 5 for brood pattern. There are no health issues. I've not taken any honey off. I've not fed. And so I saw the queen, so I put white seen. And there's nothing else really to comment on. That's as simple as that. So it only takes a minute to do that, and then I can move on to the next colony. That's the beauty of it. And you soon build up a picture of which queens are worth breeding from. And that one's got all the traits we look for. So, you know, well worth rearing a lot of offspring from her. And I try to run, you know, probably 10, 12 different breeders during the year, during the season, to keep the genetic diversity up. The last thing we want is to just have one breeder queen dominating the gene pool.